Hey guys, Nefib99 back. Just showing you a little, just doing a little commentary real quick to do a tutorial on something that I've seen that really isn't common on YouTube. It's basically teaching you how to survive on your first night, teaching you the basics. I'll probably make this into a series, I don't know yet. So, to start off, we're gonna create a new world. And just to give you guys a good seed, it was 18754. So 18754, remember that? Create. It'll take a little while. First, build your world. Pretty soon, it'll be fast every time you enter it. So, let me just make sure what settings I'm on. Alright, I'm on easy. So, as you can see, I've spawned on sand. You always spawn on sand. Some people may say this is not true, but it kind of is. It's the most common place where you spawn. So, sand is used to make windows. Windows help you with just seeing outside. Pumpkins can be used to make jack-o'-lanterns. Water has some water physics to it. I'll do that in the next. I'll show you guys some water physics in the next episode. I'll just collect some of these pumpkins because they are hard to find. Not only can pumpkins light up an area much brighter, but they can also light up in the water without going out. So, it's really useful. But the first thing you want to do when you first join in a world is collect some dirt. You want to get at least 10 pieces because sometimes dirt can really help you in tough situations. So, 10 pieces around. The next thing you want to do is find some trees and basically punch trees. What trees do is they create tools for you, and tools will help you collect raw resources. So, collect around 12 pieces, I'd say, or maybe even 10. I know I've been saying 10 a little bit too much, but you know, it's a good number. Make sure you stay close to your spawn, otherwise if you die, then you'll never it'll be hard for you to find your house. So, let's just collect some more of this wood. Alright, let me just finish this tree off. Anyways, now that you have your wood, what you first want to do is find a good place to have a shelter. Usually it's good to have it in like a small hill, sometimes even in a mountainside, but since this world doesn't have that many mountainsides, I'm guessing I'm gonna try and just do it in a hill. So all you have to do is find a nice sloping edge, like right here. And all I have to do is dig inside. Once you find this stone, all you're gonna do is take your wood, turn it into wooden planks. I'm gonna keep these two just in case, because if I don't find any coal in time, then I'll just make some charcoal. So, right here we have our crafting table. Just place that down, and let's make our tools. Make around 16 sticks just to be conservative about it, and let's make a pickaxe and a shovel. Once you have this, you want to make an axe so you could chop down some trees faster. The next thing you want to do is you want to go find some sheep. Now, I know punching sheep doesn't give you as much wool, but I mean, it helps you a lot, and it doesn't look like there's any sheep around, so I guess I'll probably show you guys all the crafting recipes in a different episode. So the first thing you want to do is dig out your home. Now, this is stone, and once you break the stone with your pickaxe, You are going to get something called cobblestone. And what cobblestone does is it's a building material. It can be used for furnaces, stuff like that. Next thing you want to do is you want to break out your walls. And remember, do not use a pickaxe on dirt or anything above a coal mineral, like iron, gold, or a diamond, or redstone, because you'll lose it. You gotta use stone. So, now that we have quite a bit of cobble, all we're gonna do is make a cobblestone pick, because we have this iron right here. And I'll show you what iron will be used for in a little while. Now, we gotta hurry, because once it gets night, everything's gonna be coming after you. Skeletons, spiders, creepers. Don't even get me started about the creepers. They're just scary. So, let's hurry up on getting this done, and we have a pretty okay shelter for now. Just collect this. Place a dirt block right there because we don't really care about the dirt. This is why dirt comes in handy. Collect your crafting bench. You wanna put it somewhere inside. Let's make a door really fast. If you hold shift while clicking an item, like, say I have an item right there. If I hold shift and click on it, it'll send it directly into my inventory without having to drag it. So, all we're gonna do is make ourselves a little door for our shelter. And, all you're gonna have to be doing is collecting some more wood. Let's make a furnace. Okay, now that we have our furnace, let's make a small wooden chest. Want to keep some wooden planks because you want to use it for fuel right here. And we're going to cook up some charcoal so we could get some torches to keep anything from spawning inside of our shelter. While that's cooking up, you want to go outside and get some more wood with that axe that you made. More wood, the better. And then, a different episode, I'll show you how to make a nice starting home out of wood. Any wood that you can't reach, just dig around for other pieces like this one. This one's kind of a colossal tree, so just take out all of its branches and crap. Alright, now that we have a decent amount of wood, this is just an OCD thing that I like to do. Just collect some birch wood because I could really use it for some charcoal. Just to keep it organized. You guys don't have to do this, but I just like doing this. There we go. One piece of wool. This right here is called the sapling. There are different types. This is a birch sapling. And then there are others called. They're just regular saplings for regular, like, pine trees. Anyways, let's get in here. We have our charcoal. All we have to do is like that. You're basically drawing out things. So we want to put up some torches. Gives it some sufficient lighting. Right here. Right here. Now then, let's collect this coal. Just want to finish off this wooden pick. More coal you get, the more lighting, and the more it'll prevent monsters from spawning. Check out this. Check out a username that goes by the name of Ethos Lab on YouTube because he does some really good videos and he teaches you all about mob spawning in one of his tutorials. I mean, he's a really cool guy. I mean, really. So let's just put some stuff away right now that we don't really need. Alright, now that we have more of these, we can make more torches. And that's basically the starting episode. See you guys later.